Welcome back. It's our last, the best of one of the evening here for the EU portion, at least, of WePlay Season 3. We do continue on into the night. Llama will be taking on after this for the Americas group stage. But let's get into game, shall we? The draft is underway, and my camera is still lagging, and it's really tilting me. But Samurai Champloo up against PRIES is our final best of one of the day. The draft has already begun. We'll get through this in a little bit. But before I do, look in my stats man, Scant, and my co-caster, Ryu. What do you know about these two teams?
I want to watch Samurai Champloo. That's what I want to watch right now.
I cannot say I've seen it. I'm not a massive anime fan.
You're missing a good one, man. It's a really good one. I was thinking there would be a spin-off of the second one. It's been so long. I'm not going to say anything else other than that, because I don't want to spoil anything. So I'll let you watch it. It's a really great anime.
I'm probably not going to watch it.
Do you watch anything?
I've watched some of the Studio Ghibli feature-length animated movies, but I've not watched any of like the manga-related like
Five
series.
Seconds remaining.
Like I haven't even watched Dragon Ball Z. Like I'm just not that person.
I mean, people say anime, it's for kids, it's for kids. It's not really
I really enjoy Studio Ghibli stuff. Like it's super good. I just never got into the whole I was watching all the TV. Like I was really big into like freaking Family Guy and Simpsons, watching all the old English TV shows. I just watched them nonstop, but I'd assume if I had been introduced to it earlier and gotten into it, I probably would be a massive nerd and just watch everything.
It just takes one good anime or one good thing, and then you're pretty much
hooked. That's what I'm worried about. I've not got enough time in the day. I can't do it. I can't have another addiction. Dota 2 takes up my time already. But the draft, let's get through this. Lundruid, Spirit, Witch Doctor, Void, Oracle, OD, Gyarokopter, and Chen taken out with Nature's Prophet, Ventral Spirit, Death Prophet, Invocatrion, and Bane are the picks so far. And we're down to the fourth pick for Samurai Champloo. Offlane, mid, two supports. Last pick is going to be their carry, so look for the Juggernaut, something along those lines. While PRIES have their Invoker for the mid. Two supports with the Bane and Treant. That really kind of classic combo we used to see from, EG, Goblack's old teams. Where you kind of run around and just punch people. Set them up, drain them out with that Leech Seed, and punch them into the ground, and with a Phoenix. Okay, well, this is definitely EGS. Treant protected with that Overgrowth, add in the Supernova. They were running this at... It was DAC, right, last year? When
this is some flashbacks now. Phoenix, Treant combo. Good old stuff. Peter revolutionizing the world with his tree.
What does PRIES need last? So both teams need a safe lane carry. And it's this awkward kind of standoff situation where if you ban out one, the opponent's going to take the one you wanted. Like, it's just mind games at this point. Ban out the Medusa. Interesting. I don't know too much about these teams, but I guess that's more of a respect ban or a targeted ban up against PRIES. Remove that Medusa out while...
They're just watching EG versus Vega right now. And they're like, oh, there's a Medusa in that game. We're going to ban it.
Oh, really?
No problem, guys. Yeah. There's...
10 seconds remaining.
Dusa is just one of those heroes that, if you're not ready for it and it's last picked, and but they do have it. Like if you don't have a defusal hero like PL or some kind of way to just get on her, silence her, or just stun her outright, and then with say a Chronosphere, then it becomes very hard just attacking her face on. And like you're right there, Juggernaut is a really good thing. To pick up here, PRIES, I think Sven's pretty good here in this situation for them if they want to pick up that carry.
Yeah, they've got the Nightmare to set up for the stun. They've got good ways of stacking Ancients and clearing things out. I'm a little worried about Samurai Champloo's mobility between Venge and Furion to really get up into those Ancients and stop Sven from farming. I would like to have a bit more mobility here. I don't know how you feel about something like an Ember Spirit, because you're dealing with a silence from DP, but just having something that can jump around the map, have some lockdown, maybe be left alone in the laning stage for a little bit.
Yeah, they don't have a Bane to really go around and catch you out with the Ember with the Fiend's Grip plus one. Nature's Prophet has to build an Orchid, and then even when he gets the Orchid, most likely he's going to need help from somebody else to get the kill. So it does add a lot of split pushing potential from PRIES, as well as him most likely not dying. It's just how do they want to do it. They can even go back for a Slark here.
What about Wave Clear?
Yeah. Slark is decent in this situation because, he can just keep farming effectively. Then he can just constantly go for these pickoffs because... Or that hero. Like, Normally what you want to do against an ancient apparition is you want to pick a bounty hunter or some hero that can just constantly keep picking off the hero because he just wants to farm in lane statically and just build up to either his Midas or his, to his Ag. So he's normally going to be alone, and then he's going to be shooting his ulties around the map. So what better way to get a global, another global hero here in the Spectre? Really punish the AA here. Now, who do you think has the better lineup here, Durka? This is...
I'm meant to ask you that, surely.
All right. If you want my opinion, I'll go first here. I think with the Spectre...
I think it's Samurai Champloo. I think Samurai Champloo has the better lineup.
All right. I don't know.
Like, my reasoning is I just don't see a way that Priest can deal with this just continual sustained push.
Remaining.
As long as laning phase isn't a massive disaster, as long as Samurai Champloo don't get crushed, remaining. You know, like 0 to 10 in the first 15 minutes, I think they are going to do very well with this draft.
I think, yeah, it depends on the early game, right? If Champloo do a really good job and rotate around correctly, get their levels, Furion puts a lot of pressure, they have a DP ulti, say at like 10 minutes, and they get tier 1 mid or bottom, then you can see easy Roshan control coming up from Champloo. But Prius, I mean, the team fight is so scary for them right now. You have Fiend's Grip that can only be canceled by like Silence and Avenge Swap. You also have the Tree plus Phoenix combo as well as Spectre. It's going to be very hard for them to team fight if they get behind early here for Champloo. So I'm going to say Prius have the better lineup because I think they're going to weather the storm early here.
We'll see how they do. Already aggressive movement into the Radiant Jungle from this Dire squad. I want to start things off with this Vengeful Spirit stun, but they're not going to find anyone.
Oh.
All of this, they do.
I thought, the Bane, my statement.
I thought the Bane would move himself back a little bit faster, but KYH is
what?
Taken out.
He didn't eat the tree,
didn't Nightmare himself, he just placed the sentry down and got taken out.
What? Okay. Well, this isn't a pub, guys. You can do that, play in pubs, but you can't do that in games. You have to be a little bit cautious there of the enemy. And well, at least they get the rune top here.
The battle begins.
Zenigata boots first over on this Treant Protector. Where on earth is he going? Is he wrapping in to try and kill the courier or something? He's moving himself all the way towards the east. Going to drop in between these tier 1 and tier 2 towers, but he's not a ranged hero. Does Treant insta-kill courier with one hit?
I think it still has like 3 or 4 HP left. I think it requires 2, but because he has boots first.
75 HP with 0 armor on the courier. 85 damage. 81 to 89 damage on the Treant. I think it's just one hit kill.
It is actually 81 to 89.
Oh. Treant might be able to find it down the bottom lane. Gedrock's the one that's actually stunned up, and with the Chilling Touch damage output, they'll look for the spin after, and now he's dead. The Spectre's gone. Samurai Champloo off to a great start already as Garter in his aggressive tri lane between the AA Venge and Juggernaut. They're only against the dual lane of Bane Spectre. It's not working out, but mid lane, it's the Treant wrapping in with a Leech Seed onto Attacker. Soul Siphon onto the tree to drain back a little bit of that life, but it's just the trade back as Attacker is forced to burn through one of his pool tangos already. Great movement in aggressively from the Treant, and giving this Invoker for Mastermind a little bit of an easier laning stage, but it does not outweigh the fact that Spectre will be sitting here with zero last hits for quite some time. They're actually wrapping in on mid again. If you can't face up against this tri lane, you move your heroes elsewhere. Attacker again with Elite Seed down, Sunstrike to secure, misses out on that one. So DP did turn to try and attack, but Death Prophet getting focused down. And this is the thing, it's the domino effect. You move into mid lane to gank because you know you can't face up against this tri lane. You force supports away from the tri lane to deal with mid, which is what the Bane, or what the Venger's doing actually now. Looking to try and rotate in, but the Radiant supports are actually moving now up towards top, so they're just trying to drag all of this attention away from the Spectre across the map to somewhere else.
Yep. You have to do this play, and I mean, Phoenix is having a really hard time here in the top lane. Finally, he'll hopefully get a gank off to really help in this situation.
Alum. TP out. There's no Nightmare and no stun.
Doesn't have sleep. Only level 1.
Level 1 Bane. Nothing to stop him from just TPing away. Mid lane attacker. Oh, if he can get the Spirit Scythe. Not going to find a Mastermind. He's going to juke himself through the trees and get away. But down at bottom lane, someone who cannot juke himself out of this one. Garter just goes to spin to win, and he's going to take down Gedrox again. The Spectre 0, 2, and 0. And guess how many last hits he has, Ryu?
I think he has
Too late. The answer's zero. The answer's zero. Attacker. A little bit of bother. Looks like he's fine. The Vengeful Spirit, considering the stun there to slow down their advance. Spirit Siphon could maybe turn this, but Treant, he's a tanky-ass hero. Could be the easiest takedown in the world, even between Avenge and a Death Prophet. All of
yeah,
these
giving
lanes.
That early kill onto the main really hurts when they're going in this aggressive tri-lane. They realize the situation when they're like, oh, well, we're going against a Spectre, we're going against a tree. I mean, he's really underwhelming in the laning phase since the Leech Seed nerf, and it's really hard to stand up to the tri-lane. They did a really nice job in rotating in the mid, but still, Invoker only has 9 CS. That's not even close to where you want to be right now if you're the Invoker. You're given free farm in the middle lane. You've gotten a lot of ganks off, and you have to kind of carry your team in this situation. They did one good thing, though. They rotated up the Spectre finally. He's got 1 CS. He really needs a Quelling Blade against the Nature's Prophet, else he's not going to get any last hits. It's just impossible when you only have 52 damage and you're up against an army right now.
It's tough stuff. I mean, they swapped these lanes to try and put the Phoenix against the aggro try. But like you're saying, the Spectre against Nature's Prophet is, you know, is better, but not by much. Looking at this mid lane, even though DP's been forced back a couple of times and even died once, you're right, Mastermind's still lacking in the CS and attacker. Once he returns to lane, he's coming straight back into it while down at bot. While Zeke already threw the stun, so Poe just TP's out. It's awkward. Awkward all round.
Oh, they got him. They got attacker in mid here.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, they do. Green will take the kill, though. Not going the way of the Invoker. I mean, he's going for the Iron Talon Tree, and something we've seen Goblack really pioneer and utilize quite effectively. But that's usually when the rest of your team are able to go around and fight and control the lanes. With an Iron Talon here, the Treant is in such an active role at this point, running around and really trying to mitigate and control the collateral damage that's being caused, that dipping back into the jungle might not be an option for him.
Yeah, it's really weird to see that. I'm kind of questioning it too. It'd be nice to have just early mana boots so you can help out your cores elsewhere. Oh, we got our Zeke scouting out. Did not place the ward there because Pwn was here, and very lucky. That would have been scouted out instantly.
They're still looking for this Bane down at bottom lane. KYH is just leeching experience, sitting in the trees. A moment. I'm gonna spot him, I think. He knows he's in there. So the TP away, and Bane gets back to the fountain. Not gonna get caught, not gonna get killed, but Garter, level 5, nearly level 6 with phase boots up. 5 minutes in, this is a free farm Juggernaut down on this bottom lane, while a moment can just pull across and control lane equilibrium as well. There's nothing gained on this bot lane, there is zero value here for Prius. Everything has to be focused up on top to help the Spectre, to mid to help the Invoker, and then you've just kind of got to really hope upon hope that this Juggernaut doesn't crush you once he gets his items. God, running forward, Pwn, he's going to have to dive away soon. That DPS. Not even a single point in healing ward.
Yeah, even if DP gets shut down in this situation, I mean, she still can just pop Exorcism easily. Oh, speaking of her, she's most likely going to die here. Our Zeke's going to help out as much as he can, but ooh, double
Siphon.
Siphon?
No, not enough.
Uphill, if it had missed, that could have been an easy turnaround, but ulti coming out already.
Third death there from attacker. Gedrock's up at top. Living armor's there. Malum was forcing him back a hell of a lot with his treads build, his attack speed. Piling in that damage and onto him while Garter down at bottom lane. He's not level 6 yet, the spin is here. He's looking for Pwn, he was trying to find the Phoenix hiding in the back, and Arzeke stun into KYH. The TP from Malum will help secure this kill, but the good body blocks and the cold feet snap. KYH swiped out of existence, and this is going to turn into a tier 1 push more likely than not. Might even find, oh, the Phoenix is TP'd out. They'll not find a secondary kill. Just Samurai Champloo applying this pressure. Making sure they control the map. Now it's their turn to try and draw the attention away from mid lane, because attacker on this DP, he might even die a fourth time. Dive in, Leech Seed out, and with a cold sap Sunstrike, attacker dodges the Sunstrike, but he's still dead to the burning fire spirits thrown out by that Phoenix.
I mean, him constantly feeding over is a huge deal because they are getting a lot of EXP top lane, though. Run down, didn't even need an Omni Splash, I saw the end of that, but so at least Spectre's almost to level 6, right? And if they can just get their levels and EXP, Prius are looking really good. So only losing one tower in the bottom lane here, I think that's a really big win for Prius in the early game. They really just need levels. and they almost have them on all the cores. Phoenix has it, and then that's when they're going to start shining.
Spectre so, has 10 last hits.
Dyer's middle tower is under attack. It's not looking good
Are you going to say it's fine? Are you going to say it's fine for the Spectre to have 10 last hits at 7 and almost 8 minutes?
It's because, like I said, look at DP, right? Okay, she has 24 compared to 37, but if you look at the overall net worth, DP's still only at 5th, and they're getting all the levels they really need on their core heroes, right? Jindrix has his level 6 now. Oh, if it wasn't for that deny there, but... I still think they're in a good... I'm not saying they're doing amazing here. Obviously, they're down 3k net worth, but... they're still just getting their levels. Let's look at that. Only 1,000, so...
Well, no boots for a moment. He's hit level 6 and he's close to that Midas. He got the recipe first. Gloves of Haste to follow shortly after. Mastermind, he does have his Midas already. Brown Boots Wand and he's got the gold money hand. This is where Invoker starts ramping up and really becoming a massive threat to deal with. The double Forge Spirits are out and these little
he's
bastards.
He's kind of babysitting too.
Oh, Zenigata caught in the Ice Blast. They catch him. Looks like the Living Armor is going to tick over. He's not going to survive this, is he? Is he? One more tick. Army Slash comes through from Garter and they find him. Should be honored.
Okay, Pwn just caused his ally to die. Radiant structures could have immediately dove away so he couldn't get the dive. It would have been very close. I think he had one more or two more ticks left from the AA Blast.
Oh, it was going to be super close. Well, Spectre finally gets some farming time in bottom lane. Poor Man Shield, Brown Boots, Wraith Band up coming to him. This lane, if he can freeze it here and keep the equilibrium where he wants it, just sitting by this tree line and cut through these trees so he has perfect vision. This is where the Spectre wants to be, and it becomes incredibly difficult for Champloo to go and really consistently deal with the Spectre and stop him from farming. But what they want to do is take down all these outer towers. Tier 2 up at drop, top does drop, and Attacker, with that Exorcism about to wear off, they're probably not going to go high ground here, and I'd really hesitate to think what would happen if they did. Up against all of this damage output from Prius, walking into double Forge Spirit is not going to be the best way to go about things. So they'll just switch across, move towards mid, push tier 1, and then you start to look at the Roshan. If Champloo can go and get that Aegis of the Immortal up on them, these team fights just become infinitely easier.
Yep. It's still Champloo's game to not lose, but they're heavily in the driver's seat. Oh, well, we have no boots on AA, so... this will be an easy kill for Invoker. Maybe.
Struggling to farm. Oh dear, the Haunt onto a moment. They're going to try and kill off the AA. It's not happening, buddy. Haunt comes to nothing. Garter just gets himself a nice couple of Forge Spirits there for his worries. Oh, Spectre. Where are you going? Are you going to walk into them? They're not going to walk into the Radiant Jungle just yet. They know where he is with that Dire Observer Ward. They see exactly where the Spectre's hiding. Start off with the stun. The dagger is there to try and get him across these trees. And he will succeed in escaping, at least for now. But just look at Garter's farm. 11 minutes in, Phase Boots Wand, and Battle Fury is 1,200 gold away. He's got the Claymore on the Courier just delivered to him already. This Juggernaut's going to be massive.
Oh yeah, they're going to have a very hard time. It has to just come in by them getting the pickoffs now. Bane almost has his level 6 here. That Haunt was very, very hopeful. And I'm very surprised he used the Alacrity there and not just used the Sunstrike. But still, all the hopes right now on this synergy between their ultis from Prius. But they can definitely get back into this game. They're just going to have to do something really soon. Like you said, the Juggernaut's just going to constantly outfarm them. The Spectre is so far behind. And they're still putting pressure on her that she will not be able to catch back up unless they teamfight.
Attacker is all of the deaths here from the Dire team. 0-4-1. Four kills from Rios. Yep. Get dumped, Dire's get ditched. But they did stack up some camps for him. Attacker pops his ulti. Interesting timing
he
to
do
that.
He did it right as the Arcane Rune was timing out.
Okay.
So that gives an extra 50 seconds here to work with.
Okay, that's pretty cool. I didn't notice the Arcane Rune, but that pushes into the tier 1. Living Armor gone. The wraparound coming in from the Radiant, though. The level 6 on Bane you were mentioning is ready and available, the Fiend's Grip, but who do they target is the big question. There's no Spectral Haunt for another 9 seconds. Can you try and wait and time this aggressive push forward with that ulti? The Radiant, they know they've got Observer Wards here, and there's no way they're going to dive in under this tier 1. It's going to be a case of Marlon continuing to farm into his Orchid, clear out some Ancients, and bide their time until that one big moment to strike.
Yeah, if Zenigati has his Nature's Guise and he goes in, then they can make that huge play, right? Overgrowth, and then you can have TPs coming over the top, but because they didn't, you just got to back out here. Meanwhile, top, they're trying to set up a play, but yeah, easily scouted out by the Treants, and KYH is... need to go back home, bro. Just maybe not home, but elsewhere. You're gonna die to the...
He's not gonna die to the Vool Assassins.
Yes, he will. He used Brain Sap.
He's
now he doesn't have enough mana.
They're nasty little devils. Enough mana for
a combo between Brain Sap and Fiend's Grip.
Oh, you're right. I'm running a little bit low there. Garter, Battle Fury. I guess it's on the courier on its way out. There we go. This is where Juggernaut starts to ramp up. 30 minutes in, clear through Ancients, go and farm some jungle camps, get into your SNY. Juggernaut going to be running rampant in this one, but they're still waiting for the Death Prophet to get into that Yule Scepter. He's got it in about 70 gold, so attackers just trying to patiently and safely farm, because Mastermind, with that Blink Dagger up, he could look to go in with a Blink Forge, Meteor Cold Snap, and quite easily kill off attacker here.
Yeah. At the same time here, we do have Juggernaut only being level 9, so that's one bad thing. Obviously, level 1 on the slash is very underwhelming. But with his Roche, should be up to level 10, or at least 10 and a half, and then he'll just get it by clearing out the Ancients. And they're going to be able to take down the tier 2s and potentially go high ground here. Wow, he didn't even get as much as I thought he would. But still, we have Blink Dagger on Invoker here. That can help set up for a lot. He has the right thing leveled up here. Ooh, TP's... Oh, he just... Hey, he canceled it. Juggernaut canceled. Oh, he got Overgrowth.
Haha. Sneaky Treant. They're not going to be able to make a go in onto this Mastermind Invoker, though. Malum still doesn't have that TP off cooldown. 20 seconds till that's ready. He's trying to hold out this split push in. And with an Ice Blast through, Mastermind's going to be pretty paranoid about what's coming in around the corner. But now he sees... Two heroes mid with Exorcism, still level 1. You don't have this level 11 Death Prophet just yet.
Oh, AA is all alone here.
Oh, you're right, with the Haunt forward, they'll find him. The dust is out. Zenigata, this little Treant getting drained out by Attacker, but that Meteor Deafening Blast was huge. Attacker self-fuels into the air, but he's going to drop as soon as Gedros comes in with a swipe through and takes him out. And Prius, they've got this 2-for-0 exchange looking into a 3-for-0 as both Aegis and Juggernaut's real life. Taken out of the game.
That's just not enough respect given to the big ulties and team fights of Prius right there. And I was looking at Gendry's. I was like, okay, it's still on the Spectre to really get back into the game because he's got nothing. And what does he do? He's got a Morbid Mask because he's going to go into the jungle. I don't even know if you can go into the jungle at this point, but... This is... still a really good team fight at the end of the day for Prius, and now they don't have DP ulti, and they're gonna just bulldoze down mid once again here.
Interesting. I kind of thought they'd use this time more wisely to farm up some more on Garter, get Attacker into that Vitality Booster, into his Phase Boots, because if you look at the DP
build...
Just get
level 11 on your Juggernaut and I'd be happy.
Yeah, well, level 11 on both of these heroes, both DP and Jug, would be incredibly potent for them. But at this point in time, a moment. He knows there was a little ward, a little sentry around somewhere, and Zeke joins in with them, but pushing into this tier 2 is definitely not the easiest thing to get around to, as Zenigata has Arcane's mech over on this tree and protector. That Iron Talon has paid off dividends for him.
And I was about to talk about that too. I was just clicking on it. Let's see how much tree has put into this game, and he's put so much work. He's... What is this? This is like a roaming bounty hunter-ish level, like a farm right now at 16 minutes. That's how absurdly farmed Zenigata is right now, and...
He's got tons of net worth. Phoenix, on the other hand, Tranquil Boots earned 1,300 gold. Is this a game where you go back for the Midas on Phoenix, or do you just try and kind of, you know, attach yourself to the mid-game? Go for that Shiva's Guard, go for, a Halberd or something?
I think Yule's in this situation you want to go for if you're Phoenix, or Lotus Orb. You need something to really cancel out the Yule's silence, as well as, you know, there's an Orchid already. I don't think they know that the Orchid's complete yet, but they knew he was building it on Furion. So you have to have some kind of insurance to where you're not, oh, I'm going to Icarus dive in. Oh, wait, shit, I got silence. I'm back where I started, and I can't cast my ulti. So But like you said, it looks like he's going. Did he sell it? Wait, did he just sell it for half price?
Who sold what?
Okay, Pwn just had a Gloves of Haste in his inventory, but he did he sell it for only 250? Is the question. I don't know. I'd have to look at the replay there.
I'm not sure.
That's 250 gold down the drain.
I can't remember if he had TP and wand before. Yeah, he had like Urn Tranquil's wand. I think you might be right because he was sitting on like 1230 when I last checked him.
Radiant's Garter is under attack.
Yeah, smoked up into this. They'll find the Bane. Easy takedown, but on the other side, a moment shredded by the meteor as Mastermind slowed down. The Phoenix Egg is gone, and this Invoker has to try and get himself into the Ghostborn form, but there's the Overgrowth. RZ cleared up. Finally, Attacker launches out his Exorcism as Garter swipes down Zenigata. And that good old Omni Slash. Just enough to finish him off under the sentry here with that Exorcism Ghost flying around. Samurai Champloo, they're not done just yet with a Yule Scepter up. This Spectre trapped, silenced, now double silenced with the Orchid from Malum, and they've killed up four. Two supports for the price of four here as Prius, the complete role reversal. And Attacker, he's got another 5-6 seconds left on his ultimate. Take down this tier two, but they cannot go high ground. They have to go and react to what's going on up the top lane.
Yeah, that was a huge misplay coming in from Pwn there. He Icarus dove in. Obviously, it's only a level one egg here, but he didn't use his Fire Spirits at all. And that's the one good thing about Juggernaut as a counter. You just use your Blade Fury and then you take off the Fire Spirits and you start attacking the egg. So that's going to help out a lot during the team fights, but he really needs just to get up those levels. They use the silence and...
and nothing. And then there was silence. Pwn, 1400. Oh, where's he going into? Dude, he just bought Gloves of Haste again. This Phoenix. He's dilly-dallying. He's going back and forth. I find this really highly unusual. Going, like, he just sold it again. What? Ryu? Are you here? Have I lost my co-caster?
Yes, she did for a second. I'm back, guys.
Phoenix just did it again.
Somebody just somebody came in the room. What happened?
Phoenix just did it again. Phoenix bought Gloves of Haste. He was on 1,460 gold. So he could have saved, you know, 90 gold for his Midas recipe. He bought Gloves of Haste, and then he sold them for half price.
I'm going crazy.
I'm super confused. Like, initially, why don't you just go straight in for the recipe if you're going for Midas? And secondly, why do you keep selling the Gloves of Haste? Garter. Good Fiend's Grip. Look at that meteor. He's straight up screwed. Prius are now on the hunt for RZ because they've got an overgrowth here. They do, just to get this Vengeful Spirit. Sunstrike out and damage is a good one. Double kill for Gedrox's Spectre, and now maybe even a tier 1 tower at bottom lane.
Mask of Madness in Spectre, 75 games this patch. This is only the second Mask of Madness built. The first one was bought by Pasha in the victory over London Conspiracy. Well, it's kind of like the comeback mechanic, right? Something cheap, effective, it helps you farm very effectively. And he still needs to have a Manta style so that he can get out of the Orchid, and it'll help out a lot against the Juggernaut Omni Slashes. So he's going to go man mode here, and this is the good thing about having the lifesteal effect, right? If you go man mode in these situations, I don't even know who would have won that team that fight right now.
I think
Orchids him?
Yeah, I kind of feel like Malum could have turned and fought that, but yeah. He doesn't know who's behind him. Oh god, Juggernaut kills off one down at bottom lane. The TP out from Treant will get him back to safety. But with all the Treants, the Catapult and the full wave there, I think the Spectre was... Yeah, well, manhandling the Nature's Prophet a little more than he really could have got away with in any other situation. Spectre, 7,000 net worth, climbing up that ladder. He's getting his farm in. But you've got to look at these items right now. He's sitting on 2,200 gold. You're talking about the Manta style to get out of the Orchid and also the DP silence. What do you feel about him just going straight into a Radiance here?
Radiance bottom tower is under attack.
I don't agree with it at all. It'll take too long for you to farm a Radiance, and you're not gonna... Obviously, it's great against these support heroes and a Furion. Not so much against the Juggernaut. You can just spin it away and help out a lot. Oh, attacker here. This strategy... Oh.
Are they going in on this? Will Scepter up attack and gets himself out of danger, but it's the Overgrowth Fiend's grip onto Garter. Attacker, he's been taken out by the Meteor, and it looks like PRIES have taken one out without anything in return, and it's a good Supernova. Clearing up the Vengeful Spirit and also forcing Garter with a moment to back themselves away. But the big question is, where is this Nature's Prophet? The hero that you kind of expect to join in the team fights and make up the numbers hasn't been available.
And I don't agree with him going for the Maelstrom. I think this is one of those games. Oh, he's going to get going on here in mid lane. Orchid's out.
There's the Sprout into the Cold Feet. Tornado going to clip and send the AA into the air. The Mastermind. He's got a Blink for the Ice Wall. He's got the Aghanim Scepter up as well. And with his cooldown and invoke, he can just keep spamming out these spells. A moment.
Oh no, dearie me.
That's a shame.
He's going to make up for it with the Sunstrike.
Is he, though?
No.
Lucky he is. TP aggressively. Malum has found the Bane Elemental. Into stun. Into death. Into grave you go. Up at top, it looks like Garter has found Gedrox. And with the Omni Slash, he clears that one up. This game is really... Like, there's no words to describe it. It's just really wonky.
It's all over the place, baby.
It's super wonky.
It's like, oh, we'll feed you some kills. Oh, wait. No, wait. We'll feed you some kills.
We'll return the favor.
Yeah,
take some gold back. Well, Garter finally gets into his secondary item there with a Madder Style 24 minutes in after a 14-minute Battle Fury. Yeah, not the best, but still, it's a progression. 6-2-4 right now. Plenty of kills to his name. Pretty much half of what his team's been able to get here. But Arnzeke's Vengeful Spirit, this level 2 swap, with the Aether Lens nearly done. This could be the hero that really controls the tempo of this game as Sunstrike scouts out the Rosh attempt from Attacker. He's going to need to pop his Exorcism soon, but he's aiming towards an Green Core straight off the bat. No BKB, nothing really to save him from Supernova plus the Invoker spells. If they can take the Aegis, it should be perfectly fine. Give it across to Garter. Attacker's DP, not the best hero to pick up Aegis Immortal. Just give it over to him.
Yeah, the only reason you would kind of give it to the DP is like, you pop Exorcism, and then you take down the tier 3 tower, or you're trying to take it, they get the kill off onto your Death Prophet, in which case, that's good, right? They forced everything on the DP, but she'll still come back to the fight, and then she still has this pure damage, Spirit Siphon, to chase down the enemy. She has Silence, so... At the end of the day, it's not even bad to really put it on her. It's just that, well, it's the rest of my team going to be dead.
Malum, he TP'd aggressively into this, and with the combo from Invoker, he's going to get swapped back by the Venge. Arzeke saves his mate, but an Overgrowth is perfectly placed between the both of them. And instead of losing one, they'll lose two. They wanted to snipe the Spectre with the Ice Blast into TP, but Sprout does not lock Spectre in place when she daggers forward.
And she's going for Radiance, too. This is... so weird and I'm not a fan of it. Just not a fan of it here in these situations. I mean, if she had Manta Style, say up at the top lane and when Juggernaut Omni Slashes, you probably survive, hopefully, in those situations. And I don't know. It's just way too good to pass up. If she gets caught out by the Nature's Prophet alone, I feel like she's just going to die just because Nature... Well, never mind. He's going back for the Ags build. So he's going less the DPS route and more for the split push here coming in from the side of Champloo.
Well, if you keep these lanes forced in, you always know where your opponents are. You can start sniping them with Ice Blast as Zenigata, their hasted treant. So you're going to be able to kill off a moment here. Well, with the help of Mastermind, he definitely will. Even looking at Arzeke, the Vengeful Spirit. Oh, the tag of the Tornado. Not going to catch an attacker. He's got second thoughts about this Mastermind Invoker sticking around for too long. The Sprout's going to miss, and the Bane Nightmare is good. Keeps Mastermind alive. Dive forward, and the Supernova in the back end of the fight. They can't focus it down, and there's the Overgrowth combination we were looking for. Can't attack the Egg. And Champloo, there are a bunch of Samurais. They're going to try and swipe down Poe, and it looks like they'll succeed. That's a lot of expenditure out from Prius, as Invoker did drop all the way in the back end of the team fight. So not only do they bust all their spells, but they lost the teamfight as well. Maybe even the Spectre. Mask of Mana's turned on. Life drained. Triple kill for Attacker. And Exorcism is available to push high ground.
I mean, that looked pretty game losing there. And it could be all over for the side of Prius. They still have the Aegis to work with. It was a nice Phoenix egg, but once again, it's just not enough. You didn't have your Spectre Haunt in there. You just died. I think it was on cooldown or something. I don't know why you didn't use it, Craven, yet, but... Tree getting chased down here. Spirit Siphon coming out. King's Boot.
Attacker has gone a bit too deep, but it looks like he's fine. 3v1, 3v2, then he got her. Poor little tree, and even with this sunray from that little old Phoenix, Attacker still keeps pumping out the damage onto the buildings. Midrax dropping to creep wave and treants, while Arzeke looking for the swap back. Garter, there's the swap. Puts Attacker a little bit further forward, but Mastermind, the one being drained out and taken down, he's gone with the buyback available. Might be forced to use it, but it's a Spectre. Haunts in aggressively to the AA, where the Maskman is down. He takes one out, but Garter's healing ward will keep them both up and happy. And Gedrox can't do anything further. With 3,600 gold saved up. Oh man, he could have a Yasha. He could have almost a Manta style done.
Radiant's middle barracks are under attack. They're just gonna lose the game right here. Nice Yule Scepter canceling out that, and this is the dead Phoenix. Omni Slash overkill. Overkill here. Top lane though, TP out away from the Furion, and just kinda have to wonder Spectre's decision to not really go. At least a Yasha, that helps out a lot for the movement speed and the farming too, but... Yeah, yeah, if you just miss up one team fight though from Prius, it's all over. Because Champloo's lineup is based on obviously split pushing here, you have the Furion to really help for the high ground, and... You caught it, man. They just snowballed too effectively from the early game. That aggressive trialing worked out superbly.
I was right. Ryu was wrong. Nah,
hey,
nah,
you know,
nah,
I
nah,
said
nah.
that Champloo, if they have
oh,
a really
matter.
Great early
it
game, they're going to win.
Doesn't matter what you said. Doesn't matter what you said. All that matters is that I was right and you were wrong.
I bet on the wrong team.
Oh, dear. Oh, well. Well, with that, it does wrap up my night and Ryu's night here for WePlay Season 3.
Wait, no. I'm actually casting with Llama next.
Oh,
so
sorry.
She extended my invitation and I'll just...
Okay.
Although I really do want to watch the EG Vega and I don't know, the Empire plus ES, so I guess I gotta get
an hour break. You have an hour break. And that's for everyone. An hour break until we come back with America's Llama Down Under, and Ryu will be casting that Archon against Power of Friendship, followed up by E-Wolves against Shazam. So make sure to come back in an hour, get your dinner, your brunch, your lunch, your breakfast, whatever time of the day it is, get yourself a snack and a meal, come back. Let's eat. Yeah, I'm gonna go home and eat, definitely.
Oh,
I'm gonna go and eat some food. Actually, all the shops are closed. I might have to go and get something from a restaurant or something. But anyway, I will be back tomorrow. 2 p.m. Zowie show match. Mineski against TNC starting at 2 p.m. WePlay continues at 5 p.m., which Toby's covering for the rest of Thursday. So make sure to check out tonight America's ESL final going on the ESL _ joinDOTA red stream. And more WePlay action coming up later. So thanks for watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow.